the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese. Hi, you're listening to an elementary lesson on Chinese Pod. I'm Jenny.
And I'm Jason.
Today, we're talking about TCM, traditional Chinese medicine.
That's right. Something very intrinsic to Chinese culture, I think.
Mm.
So, TCM, traditional Chinese medicine. How do you say that in Chinese, Jenny?
中医.
So, that's Z-H-O-N-G, first tone, and a Y-I, first tone.
Yes, that's right.
So, this word 中医 can actually have two different meanings, and they both show up in today's dialogue.
That's right. So listen to the dialogue and see if you can figure out what the other meaning is. And the dialogue today probably takes place on a subway or a train. Anyway, you're going to hear two people, a man and a woman, talking about 中医.
That's right. One person is expressing interest in what the other person is doing. So let's listen to the dialogue three times and then we'll come back and translate it.
对话第一遍。
诶,你在看什么书?
中医的书。
你是中医吗?
不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思。
我也对中医很感兴趣。 你能跟我说说吗?
不好意思,我也不太懂。
第二遍。
诶,你在看什么书?
中医的书。
你是中医吗?
不是。 不过,我觉得中医很有意思。
我也对中医很感兴趣。 你能跟我说说吗?
不好意思,我也不太懂。
第三遍。
诶,你在看什么书?
中医的书。
你是中医吗?
不是。 不过,我觉得中医很有意思。
我也对中医很感兴趣。 你能跟我说说吗?
不好意思,我也不太懂。
All right, so we're back. First, we're going to go through the dialogue line by line and translate it for you.
诶,你在看什么书?
Hey, what book are you reading?
诶,你在看什么书?
Hey, what book is it that you're reading?
诶,你在看什么书? 中医的书。
A Chinese medicine book.
中医的书。
A Chinese medicine book.
中医的书。你是中医吗?
Are you a doctor of Chinese medicine?
你是中医吗?
Are you a Chinese medicine doctor?
你是中医吗? 不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思。No,
but I think Chinese medicine is really interesting.
不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思。No,
but I find Chinese medicine really interesting.
不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思,我也对中医很感兴趣,你能跟我说说吗?
I'm interested in Chinese medicine as well. Could you explain it to me a bit?
我也对中医很感兴趣,你能跟我说说吗?
I'm also interested in Chinese medicine. Could you talk about it a little bit?
我也对中医很感兴趣,你能跟我说说吗? 不好意思,我也不太懂。
Sorry, I don't really understand it myself.
不好意思,我也不太懂。Sorry,
I don't really understand it either.
不好意思,我也不太懂。Alright,
so hopefully you caught some of that. Now we can go back and break down each line.
对, first of all, I think this dialogue is slightly challenging for Ellie, but we know that Chinese pod users love a challenge once in a while.
That's right, a challenge is a good thing. It means you can learn a lot.
好, let's start from the top.
All right, so the first line here we have...
诶,你在看什么书? 诶,你在看什么书?
So that first word is translated as hey, but it's more of a noise, right?
It's a sound. 诶,诶, second tone, which basically prefaces a question.
Yeah, it's kind of a way of getting somebody's attention, right?
对,对.
All right, so what is the question that they ask?
你在看什么书? 你在看... 什么书?
So literally, you are reading what book?
对.
So you could say this as a statement, not a question. How would you say that, Jenny?
你在看书。你在看书。
You are reading a book.
对. So this 在 creates a continuous action, an action that's taking place now.
Right, similar to the English ing, right?
对, so 在 followed by the verb. 你在看书,我在看书。
So then she responds and she tells him, I'm reading...
中医的书,中医的书。
So Chinese medicine book.
对。
So this 的 here means that the book is about Chinese medicine.
对。中医的书 Or if you're reading a book about Chinese language, you can say 中文的书
Exactly, so any subject plus 的书 is a book about that thing
对
So then the guy has another question for her
是的你是中医吗你是中医吗
So you are a doctor of Chinese medicine or a Chinese medicine doctor
Exactly, and this is where the word 中医 has another meaning.
Exactly, it's actually short for a longer phrase, which is
中医医生中医医生
So Chinese medicine doctor.
对
But you can just shorten that and say
中医中医
first tone again.
对 So the word 中医 has two meanings. It can both meantraditional Chinese medicine or a doctor of Chinese medicine.
Right, and you can know this based on the context because the person is asking, you are. So they wouldn't say, are you Chinese medicine? Right? That doesn't make much sense.
Exactly. So of course you can infer from the context.
Okay, good.
How, and followed by the question, we have a rather chunkful, mouthful of sentence.
Exactly, a nice long sentence that comes after that.
对, the girl answers, 不是。不过我觉得中医很有意思。不是。不过我觉得中医很有意思。
No, but I think Chinese medicine is really interesting.
And in this sentence, we have a very important structure, which means I think something is very interesting.
Right, exactly. So which part of the sentence there was interesting?
啊,有意思。有意思。
So very interesting.
对
so, And literally that's to have meaning, right?
是的,意思 can mean meaning. But when you hear the phrase 有意思, it means interesting.
Right, so literally it's to have meaning, but you don't have to think of it that way. You can just think of 有意思 to mean interesting as one word.
是, and of course when you add 很, 很有意思, then it means it's very interesting.
Right, so it emphasizes that interesting, right?
Mm.
So that's part of a structure in which we said, I think this is interesting. So which part of that meant I think or I feel?
觉得,我觉得中医很有意思。我觉得中医很有意思。
So I think Chinese medicine is very interesting.
对。
Welcome back to another installment of Chinese Pod Trivia. And the question for you is...For what test does ChinesePod offer preparation services for? Is it A, the polygraph, B, the colonoscopy, C, the HSK test, or D, the CAT scan?
The CAT scan?
Ooh, sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, the HSK test. That's right, ChinesePod will thoroughly prepare you to pass this rigorous test of proficiency in Chinese. ChinesePod.com/HSK.
All right, Jenny, so could you give us a couple simple examples using the same structure, saying that you think something is very interesting? Or...
可以。For example, 我觉得中文很有意思。我觉得中文很有意思。
So we took out the 中医 and we replaced it with 中文。
对。
Which we all know is Chinese language, right?
是的。And if you're listening to this podcast, chances are you probably agree with my statement.
I hope so. Right? So I think Chinese language is very interesting.
Exactly. So just place the noun, the topic, after 我觉得, and then follow that with 很有意思。
Good. So I think something is very interesting. Good. All right. So this guy is also interested in Chinese medicine, and he wants to hear a little bit more about it.
对。
Okay. So how did he say this then, Jenny?
我也对中医很感兴趣，你能跟我说说吗？我也对中医很感兴趣，你能跟我说说吗？
All right, so let's break down that first part, which said, I'm also interested in Chinese medicine.
And obviously, the key structure here is to be interested in something.
Right, so this is a verb now, and it's no longer the adjective of interesting. It's I am interested in something.
Mm.
And there's a special structure we have here in this sentence that can help us understand how to say that.
对, 就是对 something 很感兴趣. 对, 中医 很感兴趣.
So this 对 is fourth tone, and it means towards, right? So we have this towards something to be interested.
Mm.
And in our example here, we have 中医, so 对, 中医. And then what was that verb to say to be interested in?
很感兴趣, 很感兴趣.
So very interested in. So interested in is what?
感兴趣, 感兴趣.
So I'm very interested in.
对.
All right, so let's get another example using that same pattern to say I'm very interested in something.
好, and this example actually came from Jason when we were prepping for this lesson. You said, 我对女人很感兴趣.
We asked for an example. It was the first thing that came to my mind.
好, 我对女人很感兴趣.
And as we know, 女人 is women, right?
对.
So I'm very interested in women.
Well, it's very natural. There's nothing wrong with that.
Right, exactly.
那我也可以说, 我对吃很感兴趣.
I'm very interested in food or eating, right?
对,我对吃很感兴趣.
And this is super useful. You can put anything in there to say you're interested in something.
对, just sandwich this something between 对 and 很感兴趣.
All right, so what about 我对你很感兴趣?
Ah, you can say that too.
I'm so interested in you, right?
But it's a really bad, sleazy pickup line. So
right,
I don't really encourage you to use it.
Good to know.
Okay, and this guy wants to learn more about 中医, so he asks the girl, 你能跟我说说吗? 你能跟我说说吗?
So you can with me 说说吗? And this 说说 is just a kind of like a little set phrase that means to explain something a little bit or to say more about it, right?
Exactly. And I suggest you remember the phrase 跟我说说 as a whole.
Yeah, exactly. So just think of it as a set phrase for to say more about something to me.
对.
So the order is different in Chinese. To me, say a little bit more.
是的, 跟我说说, 跟我说说.
Good. All right, and it turns out that this girl, why is she reading this book? Because, sorry, she doesn't understand it very well herself.
Yes. 所以她说, 不好意思, 我也不太懂. 不好意思, 我也不太懂.
So that first part being a set phrase for sorry, and the second part being, I also don't really understand.
对, 我也不太懂, 我也不太懂.
So the verb here is 懂, to understand, right?
对.
And that's third tone.
是的, 第三声. So 不懂 means don't understand. And if you don't understand something too well, you can say 不太懂, 不太懂.
Right, so that's just like English. The 太 means too. So if you put that between, I don't too understand, so I don't really understand it too much.
对,不太懂,我也不太懂。All
right, so let's go back and listen to the dialogue three more times.
对话第一遍。诶,你在看什么书?
中医的书。你是中医吗?
不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思。
我也对中医很感兴趣,你能跟我说说吗?
不好意思,我也不太懂。第二遍。诶,你在看什么书?
中医的书。你是中医吗?
不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思。我也对中医很感兴趣,你能跟我说说吗?
不好意思,我也不太懂。第三遍。诶,你在看什么书?
中医的书。你是中医吗?
不是,不过我觉得中医很有意思。我也对中医很感兴趣,你能跟我说说吗?
不好意思,我也不太懂。
Okay, so hopefully when you heard the dialogue again, you could pick out more of the vocab and more of those patterns.
是的。 Jason, I have a question for you now.
Okay.
你觉得中医有意思吗? 你觉得中医有意思吗?
Do I think Chinese medicine is interesting? Absolutely, actually, I do. I find it very interesting. It's a very ancient tradition, so I feel like it deserves
Have you experimented with it?
A little bit. Not as much as some other people have, but I have done acupuncture, which is a form of zhongyi or Chinese medicine. And I've done massage quite frequently. And given that the type of massage done in China uses acupoints.
Medicinal
massage. Exactly. All right. So, Jenny, I have a question for you.
How?
Are you interested in Chinese medicine? 你对中医感兴趣吗?
我对中医不太感兴趣。
So you're not too interested in Chinese medicine.
对.
Hopefully you're more interested in it than I am.
不太感兴趣. Well, actually I only said it to reinforce the pattern 不太.
Right.
不太感兴趣.
So even if some Chinese people maybe say, I'm not too interested in Chinese medicine or something like that, it's almost unavoidable. It's so ingrained into Chinese culture, right?
Yeah, it's part of daily life in China.
Exactly.
When we get sick or when we want to maintain well-being, I think most Chinese will use some parts or some elements of zhongyi in their life.
Right, some wisdom from zhongyi, right? Like what clothes to wear during what times of the year, all that kind of stuff.
是的. And with foreigners, besides zhongyi, I think they also might find feng shui 很有意思.
Exactly. We all know about feng shui in the West, I think.
是啊, Jason, 你觉得风水很有意思吗?
Yeah, actually, I think it's pretty interesting. I don't know much about it, to be honest.
It's very intriguing, right?
Yeah. I remember when I was younger, it was very popular in the US, but people didn't know how to pronounce the pinyin, so they would say feng shui.
对. And now, you know, the correct pronunciation should be shui. 风水.
So wind, water, 风水.
没错. Okay, that's it for today's lesson. As always, if you have any questions, please go to ChinesePod.com. We'll be very happy to answer them.
That's right. We'll be there waiting for you.
Thanks for listening. See you next time. 再见.
See you next time. 再见.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.ChinesePod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 1547. So just go to www.ChinesePod.com/1547 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.ChinesePod.com/1547.